Are we all happy our phones are off or on silent? Could everybody please stand for our bride?
Some people here just for the fame. Some people live for the power.
May I begin by welcoming you all here today to the marriage of Mandy and Colin. We have been invited here today to share with Mandy and Colin a very important moment in their lives. Colin and Mandy met 11 years ago while backpacking in Oz. Colin moved into the apartment below Mandy and a friendship soon formed. But it wasn't until a chance encounter in Brisbane that a romantic relationship was formed then. They both moved back to Dublin in 2007. They got engaged on Wednesday, the 26th of June, 2012. Mandy had just come in from work and Colin was waiting with a bottle of champagne and simply asked, "Will you marry me?" Off the couple set to see the Red Hot Chili Peppers, a perfect day just for themselves to celebrate their engagement. They didn't tell most of the people that they know until a few weeks later at Mandy's 30th birthday party. They were blessed with the birth of their daughter Freya in October 2014. When I asked Colin to describe Mandy, he said she is very outgoing and funny. She definitely has her own way. Quirky. She is a very active person who also likes her sleep. She is a great mom who likes the odd glass of wine. She takes great pride in her appearance and Freya's. Everything has to match. We are opposites in some ways, but we just work. She makes me feel amazing. She makes me feel safe, complete, and secure in our life together. When I asked Mandy, she said Colin is a great dad who is very loving and caring. He is the biggest support to me. We have disagreements, and 2 minutes later, be laughing our heads off together. We make a great team and he's my best friend. He is a very positive person who always puts me in a good mood. I'm a very lucky person to have him. He makes me feel so positive, happy and loved. In the years they have been together, their love and understanding for each other has grown, and now they have decided to live their lives as husband and wife. Love isn't just a word, it's an action. Love is involuntary. The ancient Greeks called love the madness of the gods. Love means so many different things to so many different people. Love is reaching your dreams together. Love is the connection of two hearts, the bearing of your soul, and the acceptance of another. It means the world to both of them that you are here to witness their wedding vows and celebrate their marriage. So I invite you to leave behind the worries and concerns of everyday life and join us in this celebration of love. What is marriage? A joyful marriage has never been too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. Let your courtship not end with the honeymoon, but continue throughout all the years. Your marriage will be a great journey of surprises, joys, and miracles. Above all, remember that your love for each other will prevail. No ceremony can create your marriage. What this ceremony can do is witness and affirm the choice you have made to begin a new life today as husband and wife. Marriage is not an event, but an inner spiritual journey. Be who you are and say what you feel, because those that mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. And now I'm going to ask Lisa to step forward for our first poem, please.
Sydney, Australia is where it all began. A year of travelling without a plan. 56 Coogee Bay Roads is where we first met. A madhouse it was. The poor neighbours never slept. It wasn't till Brisbane things start getting serious. We were boyfriend and girlfriend. Oh, holy Jesus. 2014, a year two became three. Freya was born. We were so happy. The joy and happiness she brings fills our days with laughter. She always gets what she wants. We know who she takes after. So here we are today, 11 years on. Who would have thought it'd have taken this long? Let us celebrate. Let the celebrations begin. And a night full of dancing. What cracks we're gonna have with our family and great mates. And that was written by Colin, by the way.
Family and friends, we're now going to have the first part of our unity candle ceremony. I'm going to ask Colin and Mandy to join me on this side of the table, please, along with both moms, Rita and Anne. Okay. Colin and Mandy, in the lighting of the unity candle, you were symbolizing your lives as individuals and as a family. The candle you are about to light is a candle of marriage. Its fire represents the light of two people in love. This candle before you is a candle of commitment because it takes two people working together to keep it aflame. This candle is also a candle of unity because both must come together, giving a spark of yourselves to create new life. Your mothers gave you light by bringing you into this world. It is only fitting that they give you the same light on the day of your marriage as you take your first steps as husband and wife. Rita, please light the taper and pass it to your daughter. Mandy, as you light your candle, let it be a symbol of the light shining inside of you, remembering how special you are. Anne, please light the taper and pass it to your son. Thank you. Colin, as you light your candle, let it be a symbol of the light shining inside of you, remembering how special you are. These two outer candles represent your lives up to this moment. They are two distinct lights, each bright and shining on their own. Family and friends, we're now going to enter into our handfasting ceremony. This is the oldest recorded marriage ceremony performed in Ireland. It was first recorded in our old Breton law. And this is where we get the expression, tying the knot on your wedding day. So Mandy and Colin, I'm going to ask both of you to please stand. I should move the chairs. And then again. For this ceremony today, we are going to use Mandy's Nana's scarf. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours in your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will help you hold your family as one. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Our prayer for you today is that both of you will use these hands to build a marriage where all your dreams come true.
Trapped.
Well, it was lucky you both said it. Family and friends, we're now going to enter into our marriage ceremony. This is the legal part of our ceremony today. You ready?
Yeah.
Colin, do you hereby state that you have read and understand the list of civil impediments to marriage, and do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or other lawful hindrance to your proposed marriage with Mandy?
I do.
Mandy, do you hereby state that you have read and understand the list of civil impediments to marriage, and do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment or kindred or affinity or other lawful hindrance to your proposed marriage with Colin?
I do.
It is now that I, Graham Barrett, in accordance with the rights of the Spiritualist Union of Ireland, do solemnize this your marriage, according to the laws of the country and the laws of God. Before you, Colin and Manny are joined together in the presence of God, my presence, and in the presence of these witnesses. I am bound, as you know, to remind you publicly of the solemn and the seriousness and the binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary and full commitment of two people to each other. It is made in the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others, and is entered into with the desire, the hope, and the firm intention it will last a lifetime. Colin. Colin, do you take Mandy in marriage to be your wedded wife, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth and in forsaking all others?
I do.
And do you, Mandy, take Colin in marriage to be your wedded husband, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth and in forsaking all others?
I do.
Do we have the rings, please, Darren? Just slip your hands out, I'm not.
So you just have the ring. One job.
Mandy didn't give him a class.
Well done.
So Colin, I'm going to ask you to place your left hand out with your palm up. That's it. And you want to place your left hand over his. This is where you both get to make a personal wish on your wedding rings before you exchange them. The ring is an ancient symbol, so perfect and simple. It has no beginning and has no end. It is a circle, for love that is given comes back around again. Your rings are precious because you wear them with love. They symbolize your commitment and marriage. They remind you of who you are, where you have been, and where you are going. As you wear them through time, they will reflect not only who you are as individuals, but who you are as a couple. Mandy?
Yeah.
Mandy? I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
To respect you.
To encourage you.
To always be there for you.
To help you.
Through the bad times.
And I promise.
I will try not to talk over you.
Mid-sentence.
Do you want to? Do you want to read yours?
I was in the hand, yeah. Mandy, not though.
You had to show me off there, that's
yeah.
There's yours there.
We have to push this on because we know it's not going to get far.
Colin, I promise to love you with all my heart, to respect you, to encourage you, to always be there for you, help you through the bad times, and I promise, sorry, to always laugh at you, but not at your puns.
Doesn't go on at all. Doesn't go on at all, Mary.
Colin and Mandy have declared before us they will live together in marriage. They have made special promises to each other. They have symbolized it by taking vows, exchanging rings, and tying hands. So therefore, on your behalf, on behalf of the community and the sight of God, I now declare them to be husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Family and friends, we are now going to have the second part of our unity candle ceremony. The two outer candles symbolise your separate lives. In lighting the centre candle, this represents that your two lives are now being joined together as one. I would like to ask you to remember when it was in your relationship that you first realised you were truly in love. With that thought, I now invite Colin and Mandy to light their marriage candle. They are lighting this candle as a symbol of unity as husband and wife for the rest of their lives. Family and friends, we are now going to have the prayers of the faithful. I'm going to ask Shane, Mary, Evie, Philomena and Yvonne to step forward, please.
Pray for Nana Rita, Anne and John, having given Mandy and Colin life at the beginning. They now see them build a new and happy life together. Lord, here.
We pray for the love of Mandy and Colin. May it grow deeper each day, and may that love strengthen and comfort them on their journey through their life together. Lord, hear us.
Our gracious ears.
We thank God for our daughter Freya,
We pray for all the children in our lives. May they grow up in the knowledge that they are loved and cherished by their families. Lord, hear us.
We pray for Mandy and Colin as they begin married life together. May their home be full of joy and happiness, and may they always find happiness in each other.
Thank you.
For all the friends and family of Mandy and Colin, may they live happy lives and be safe from harm. Lord, hear us.
So Mandy and Colin, I'm going to ask you both to stand out in the front again, please. Mandy, there's your flowers. Family and friends, we come to the closing of our ceremony today. Spirit of love and life, out of this world, two souls have found each other. Their destiny should now be woven into one design and their joy should not be known apart. Mandy and Colin, may your home be a place of happiness for all who enter it. A place where the old and the young are renewed in each other's company. A place for growing, a place for sharing, a place of love. May those who are nearest to you be constantly enriched by the beauty and bounty of your love for one another, and may your days be good and long upon the earth. On behalf of the newlyweds, Mandy and Colin, I would like to thank you all for not only being here today to help them both celebrate their marriage ceremony, but for the love and support you have shown them over the years. Could everyone please give a big round of applause for the new Mr. and Mrs. Hopkins?